Kailash. Today I'll describe one or two incidents. As I said yesterday itself, I lost all my shyness to talk about mystery and mysticism and mystical truths and expressions and experiences. I think this Kailash Yatra was a turning point in all incarnations' mission. Shankara went, and that was a turning point for his mission. After coming back from Kailash only, Shankara established the monasteries, the pitas. He created his mission after coming back from Kailash. Actually, in Kailash, Mahadeva gives 5 Atmalinga and the Saundarya Lahari. Please understand, Saundarya Lahari is not composed by Shankaracharya. It is Mahadeva who composed. Because if you see the description, such a romantic description of Mother, Devi, except Mahadeva, nobody can do. Nobody is authorized to do. Saundarya Lahari is full of extraordinary, beautiful description of how Devi is. Her Saundarya, her glory, her grace, Shankara cannot do and not authorized to do. So naturally, Mahadeva gifted. Mahadeva asks actually Shiva, Shankara. Shiva asks Shankara, what do you want? Shankara says, whatever you keep it as a most close to your heart, give me that. Then Mahadeva says, once Devi was just lost in my glory, listening to my teachings, Shiva Sutras. But the beauty was so graceful, wonderful. I just lost myself in that glory and composed few verses to describe how Devi was looking. So this is the most closest thing to my heart. I'll gift you this. So Shankara gave Saundarya Lahari and 5 Atmalingas. Mahadeva gave it to Shankara. Shankara comes down from Kailash with that and installs five pitas. Kanchi, Sringeri, Dwarika, Puri, Joshimath, Badrigashram. So these are the 5 places he establishes pitas and keeps Saundarya Lahari as an important book for people to remember Devi, meditate on Devi, then establishes his whole mission. Please understand, all 5 mutts, Devi is the Adidevata. Even though Atmalinga is a deity, the God is Devi. Devi only is worshipped. Even in Atmalinga, it's called Chandramouli Ishwara. Of course, Shiva Puja is done. Naturally, for the Linga, Shiva Puja only will be done. But Devi became a main deity in all pitas. I can say that many of the masters, avataric mission, the mission in their incarnated life has taken a beautiful, big, positive turn after the Kailash Yatra. I am seeing very clearly, even with us, that is happening. It's already happening. When we started, for Kailash itself, I just know something great is happening in my body, in my system. Just one day before we reached Manasarovar, I saw a huge darshan. The whole Kailash is partying. All Rishi, Muni, Kinnara, Kimburuda, Deva, Gandharva, Yaksha, all of them are just dancing, singing, jumping. The front line I saw Kalabhairava, Ganesha, Subramanya. Ganesha I could see very clearly. Usually I don't see visions and darshans. I only know two spectrum. One, the spectrum where I am relating with you guys, physical. And the other, my space, the eternal, no form, no name. Then I thought, how can this be? How can I see vision? I saw it is not even vision. It was happening in physical plane. All of them have come down to physical plane and started celebrating. I thought, oh God, what is happening? What is going on? Around maybe the chronological time of our physical plane, around 15 minutes I saw. I'll describe the whole thing and reshoot the whole thing and show it to you guys how the whole thing looked. I saw Ganesha just sucking the somarasa through his trunk. Half he's drinking and half he's splashing around. And doing all wild steps like this and all. And dancing. All the South Indian movie. Typical those steps. With his big belly. And jumping, partying. Then I know. Wow. Something extraordinary is going to happen. Actually, after that, when I started materializing, I told, if really Ganesha gave me darshan, let something, some prasadam from Ganesha happen. Immediately, one Rudraksha, just like Ganesha, appeared. Got materialized. Then I know, it is not my fantasy or hallucination, it's a darshan. Ganesha really happened. All these guys are just enjoying. Because after Shankara, first time an incarnation is going to Kailash again. Visiting Kailash. We land before going to Kailash itself. Our guide said, today we are reaching Manasarovar, but we will not be able to see Kailash because last 1 week it's cloudy, weather is too bad. We may be able to see tomorrow or day after tomorrow, but no guarantee. I said, relax. He did not understand. I told him, we will see Kailash now. He said, how can it be? For last 1 week, people are not seeing. I said, that and all is different. This is different. Don't bother. Just do what I am saying. Anyway, the car went near the place where people used to have the first darshan of Kailash. The moment they stopped, all of us got down. We could see Manasarovar, but Kailash is completely covered with cloud. I thought, what is this? We all have come from all the way. I just said, Mahadeva, please remove the clouds. Let's all have your darshan. All it took only 5 minutes. Much quicker than ashramites. Just all the clouds moved. There Kailash was. Standing. Eternally. As old as time, as new as present, as old as time and as new as present moment, he was there giving darshan to all of us. Suddenly I saw the body was in samadhi and radiating the ecstasy and joy. I jumped out of the car. literally, saying, there, this is Kailash. And I just stood there. I could see very clearly the happening means the male and female energy of the cosmos, Shiva and Parvati, like a huge circle, not even one direction, in all 360 degree, this way, like a huge happening. One end of that happening was in my Anandaganda, the other end was on Kailash, the ground, under the ground, it was touching Manasarovar, above sky. Connecting my Anandaganda, Manasarovar, Kailash and the sky, the whole thing was happening. I have no other word except the word happening. See, imagine if the yin yang, that symbol, is rotating in a huge scale. One side touching, one corner touching the sky, other corner touching the Kailash, other corner Manasarovar, other corner my Anandaganda. Huge rotation. This is one view of that. But this was not happening only in this way. It was happening this way, complete 360 degree. How will you imagine now? It was just happening. Life was happening. I just stood there with folded hands. In few minutes I saw body was overflowing. Eyes were overflowing. You can't even call that as emotion because I am not an emotional guy. As I said, even when I realized I am an incarnation, I did not become emotional. I said, what next? It was just flowing. Tears rolling. First time, other than Arunachala, in some place, I fell flat. You should all know, even in front of our Anandeshwara, I never fall flat. Even in front of Banyan Tree, I never fall flat. Only to Arunachaleshwara, I have reserved that. Falling flat is the honor I give only for Arunachala. And touching the ground and putting it on my forehead, that sand, that is also reserved only for Arunachala. But beyond my control, I offered my complete Sashtanga Namaskar to Kailashanatha. Of course, one and the same. But it was just a scene to be seen. Experience to be experienced, the happening. I can give anything for that one experience. We have video clipping of me asking Kailashanatha, asking all those clouds to move out, and those clouds giving way. We will see the video clipping now. Kailashnath Mahadev ke jai. I'll move the cloud now.
In the valley, one valley there.
No. In few minutes, that will be cleared. By the time we go around, we will have the darshan of Kailash. We'll see.
They
started opening.
Yes.
They started opening. Manas Mata ke jai. Lifting, clearly lifting, you see.
அங்க வரா.
See that, yeah, it's lifting.
Yes, yeah. There. Ah. Yeah.
बोलो कैलाश नाथ महादेव के
जय।
शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय नमः शिवाय।
आर यू गाइस एबल टू सी दिस स्ट्रेट ऑन?
Oh, yes.
The cloud is lifting, you see?
Yes, it's lifting.
The hill.
Yes. Ah.
Two brown mountains like that one.
Oh my God, it's snow capped. That's the area that you can see.
Come on, by the time you go and settle down, it'll all be clearly see. Let's go and see. Open the shade. And creation energy, which we call Shiva and Devi, just the both celebrating, just like a, you can call it as a dance or whatever you want, you can call like a something going on, that alive happening. I saw it was happening. And only I saw the Kailash. Did you all guys see?
Yeah. Yes.
Before I put my head down, yeah. I saw very clearly. Yes. Only when I put my head down to do namaskar, it covered. Yes. Did you guys observe?
We saw that. Yes.
Huh?
The temple.
Huh? See, when he showed me, then I came down. I came out. When I put my head down to do, when I bent my head down, only it got covered. In few seconds, it got covered.
Dilok Gosad.
You'll open now again. By the time you'll go to the place to settle down, you'll open completely, you'll see. You'll see fully. I told him no cloud for next 4 or 5 days. Till we all leave, no cloud, he will give full darshan. Clear darshan. See, already opening. He's already opening. You guys see?
Yes.
Opening.
Oh, yeah.
That was our darshan first from here.
You guys will see now. Hmm? Actually, you guys will know what you saw. All this punya will go to all of you guys. Now, whatever I saw, it creates a huge energy. Huge energy and huge punya. And it does not, I don't enjoy anything. I neither enjoy punya nor enjoy papa. So, I give it to all of you. It go to all of you. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, and share the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.